Hidden in the ancient book of Genesis, there are major keys to understanding mysteries concerning God's plan for your life and for the world as a whole. So says the fascinating Bible expert you'll hear today on Jewish Voice.
Shalom and welcome to Jewish Voice, a program to help you to understand the Jewish roots of your Christian faith, Bible prophecy, and world events surrounding Israel. Well, if you want to understand the Bible in context, then you have to understand from the beginning. You have to go back to the book of Genesis, where it all began. The opening scenes of Genesis are the redemption story. And as you dig into the story, you'll discover that it reveals mysteries. Mysteries in place from the beginning of time, and that will help you to better understand God's plan, his future plan, for the world and the blessings that he has in store for you. Here to help us unlock the mysteries in the book of Genesis that actually reveal God's plans and purposes for our lives and the future, truths that are important today, just as they were over 4,000 years ago, is my friend, and he's a well-known author and end-time expert, Dr. Ron Rhodes. Ron, welcome back.
Good to see you again.
Well, we are shifting from our usual conversations on the book of Revelation to the book of Genesis, and this is going back to the very beginning. Genesis? Why your focus on Genesis?
Well, you know, there is a connection between Genesis and Revelation. You know, there's a purpose why I wrote Genesis and Revelation with a 40-day approach. You see, back in the Genesis book, we find the creation of the heavens and the earth. In the book of Revelation, we find the creation of the new heavens and the new earth. Back in the Garden of Eden, Adam and Eve were barred from the tree of life, but in the book of Revelation, they're restored to the tree of life. You know, back in the book of Genesis, Satan is active in causing man to sin, and that leads to mourning and death and pain and suffering. But then when you get to the book of Revelation in the eternal state, we find that Satan is eternally quarantined. We find that sin is gone, no more mourning or pain or suffering. You know, back in the Old Testament, we find that God created the sun and the moon in order to light up the earth and so forth. We find that in the book of Revelation, in the eternal state, that the sun and the moon are no longer needed because the glory of the Lamb lights up the eternal city. The point that I'm making is that there's a close connection between Genesis and Revelation. In one, we find paradise lost, and in the other, we find paradise restored. Now, here's something I found
to be truly bookends. I'm hearing you.
They're bookends.
They're really bookends.
And what I've discovered in my own devotional life is that reading the book of Revelation brings a blessing. Reading the book of Genesis brings a blessing, but reading them both together and seeing how these relate to each other in this way, it brings a manifold blessing.
And it really helps to tie together the idea that the Bible in its entirety is God's word, and it's intricately connected from Genesis to Revelation.
You know, what's amazing is that the story of redemption that begins in Genesis and goes all the way through the book of Revelation, it's part of God's eternal plan of salvation. Jonathan, did you know that before you were even created, God knew you and God had a plan to save you? He knew that you'd be fallen in sin. He knew that I'd be fallen in sin. He knew that Adam and Eve would eat of the forbidden fruit, but he had an eternal plan of salvation. And human history is but the unfolding of God's redemptive plan. And it all begins in Genesis. You know what the word Genesis means, right?
I do.
Beginnings.
Yes.
It is the beginning of so much.
Hey, we have to take a break. When we come back, I want to talk about the idea of covenants rather than covenants. It's not just the Old Testament or the Old Covenant or the New Covenant. It's more than that, and that's where I want to pick up. Also, the hidden Jesus in Genesis. Jesus, Yeshua, is actually found in the book of Genesis. Really fascinating. And then later in the show, a tribe who claimed to be descendants of King Solomon and the Queen of Sheba. Is it possible? Well, we're going to find out in a moment. First, some important news. Take a look.
Your gracious gift in support of the work of Jewish Voice right now will make you a vital part of providing life-saving medical help to some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. Today, we are urgently preparing for one of our next medical clinics to bless a remote lost tribe community in Zimbabwe, the Lemba, who consider themselves descendants of the priestly tribe of Levi, who have been practicing distinctly Jewish customs for centuries. Our medical teams provide more than just physical care and comfort. They share God's love and the good news that Jesus is their true Messiah. Today, we urgently need your help to equip and fund this vital outreach. Will you be a blessing to these suffering Jewish people? Time is literally running out for many of the most vulnerable there, especially infants and toddlers, and that without our immediate help, some of these precious sons and daughters of Abraham may die needlessly for lack of basic medical care. But you can help save them. But we must act now. Call or click to share life-saving help right now, and we'll send you two very special resources as an expression of our thanks. For any gift of support today, we will send you Ron Rhodes' unique and enlightening 40 Days Through Genesis, Discover the Story That Started It All, the exciting book mentioned on today's broadcast. You'll also receive Jonathan Burness' remarkable CD teaching titled The Gospel According to Moses, revealing the startling truth that for centuries before the birth of Messiah, the gospel message was embedding in Psalm 90, a prayer of Moses. Both are yours when you share any gift in support of the life-changing outreaches of Jewish Voice. And if God has blessed you with the means to share a gift of $150 or more today, we have even more gifts to share as an expression of our gratitude. In addition to the two resources just mentioned, we'll also send you a beautiful and inspiring work of art, a three-dimensional replica of the Ark of the Covenant, carried by members of the priestly tribe of Levi. Plus, Jonathan Burness' eye-opening 2-CD teaching titled God's Plan for Israel. Finally, as an ongoing expression of our thanks for choosing to help so many in need, you'll also receive our illuminating and inspiring magazine, Jewish Voice Today. Please remember, God has promised to bless those who bless the Jewish people. To share an urgently needed gift in support of this vital outreach and request your thank you resources, please call, click, or write now. And remember, your generous gift will make you a part of extending life-saving medical help to some very needy Jewish people. Please remember, the days are short and the needs of these people are critical. Please act now. Hidden in the ancient book of Genesis, there are major keys to understanding mysteries concerning God's plan for your life and for the world as a whole. So says the fascinating Bible expert you'll hear today on Jewish Voice.
If you just tuned in, I'm speaking with Dr. Ron Rhodes about his latest book, 40 Days Through Genesis, Discover the Story That Started It All. And you talk about Genesis. You mentioned to us that Genesis and Revelation are actually bookends.
Yeah.
From Genesis to Revelation and connecting them together. Genesis and Revelation, you gave some great examples. I want to get to the book in just a few minutes, but I want you to talk about the idea of covenants. It's oversimplified by most believers who see the old and the new and the old is done, but there are covenants in Genesis that are, and they're important today.
Well, you know, God is a God of revelation to begin with. He is the aggressor in making himself known. God has also indicated that he desires to have personal relationships with his people. And that's kind of like a foundational background to understand the fact that God does make covenants with human beings. And perhaps one of the most famous of all covenants is the Abrahamic covenant in Genesis 12 and then repeated throughout the rest of Genesis. And in fact, elements of the Abrahamic covenant are repeated actually throughout the rest of the Old Testament. And in that covenant, God promised Abraham unconditionally, underline that word, unconditionally, that God would give him many, many descendants, so many that you can't even count them, more than the stars. Also, God promised to make his name great. One of the best things I think that the covenant promised is that through somebody that descends from him, all the people of the earth would be blessed. Now, who do you suppose that's talking about?
That's an amazing Genesis 12.
That's right.
Amazing prophecy in verse 3 that through him all the nations of the earth will be blessed. The son of Abraham.
That's right. And of course, you know, when you get to the New Testament in the book of Matthew, for example, the Gospel of Matthew, what's the first thing that that Matthew does? Since he's writing a gospel to Jewish people, what's the first thing he does? He establishes that Jesus descended not just from Abraham, but from David, in fulfillment of the Davidic covenant in 2 Samuel 7 and the Abrahamic covenant in Genesis 12. Because any good Jew in the first century would know that the Messiah had to descend from those two.
I could tell you about how that impacted me. Those genealogies are there for us Jews. They really matter to us. And when I saw that Jesus, who I understood was the God of the Christians, was the son of David, the son of Abraham, it really changed things for me.
Awesome.
Yeah, awesome. It was an awesome experience indeed. Talk about names, the names of God revealed in Genesis and what we can learn about God.
You know, it's so fascinating when you think about it, because in the Bible, names are revelatory. They tell you something about the person who has that name. And so when we look at God, for example, God is called Yahweh. And that is a name that indicates eternal self-existence. There's never been a time when Yahweh did not exist. He never came into being at a point in time. He is truly the eternal one. A lot of scholars today also say that implicit in the term Yahweh is his covenant faithfulness. You see, Jonathan, God is a promise keeper. And when he makes an unconditional promise, he will fulfill it. That's part of the meaning of Yahweh. He's also Elohim. That's a name that means strong and mighty one, powerful one. He, as the powerful one, he created the universe. Elohim is so powerful that he spoke the word and the universe leapt into existence. He's also Adonai. Adonai means Lord and Master. He is the sovereign one. He's in charge of us. He is the Lord of hosts. That means that he's the commander of the angelic armies. And by the way, those angelic armies will return with Christ at the second coming. I'm pretty sure it's going to be videotaped, so I'm looking forward to that. Now, here's something else
Jewish
to think
voice
about.
Cameras, by the way, will be
on
site.
That's exactly right. Jewish voice is going to be there to capture it. He's also God our rock, God our shield. See, there's a lot of compound names that are used of God in the Old Testament, and they indicate different things about God. For example, when we call God our rock, that means that he is our rock-solid Savior who keeps us no matter what. When we call God our shield, that means that no matter what enemy is attacking us, no matter what is coming against us, even if it's the powers of darkness, God is our shield. We turn to him because he is our defender. So the point that I'm making to you is that in Genesis and throughout the rest of the Old Testament, God's names are revelatory names. And by the way, Jonathan, God is the one who told us these names. These are not names that we made up about God. But God himself told us these
names. It's clearly self-disclosure.
Yeah.
Now, speaking of revelation, in the names of God, Genesis also reveals the Messiah.
Yes.
In the book of Revelation, we have, as one person put it, the Messiah concealed and the new revealing the Old Testament. So the it's concealed in the Old. So talk about Yeshua concealed in Genesis.
Well, you know, this is such a rich study. It really is. We know that the Redeemer was promised in Genesis 3:15, right after the fall. So God showed his mercy right there. The Redeemer's coming. We also saw the prophecy in the Abrahamic covenant that the divine Messiah would be born from Abraham's line. But beyond that, we find actual manifestations of the pre-incarnate Christ, the pre-incarnate Yeshua, appearing among his people. Now, how do we know that? How do we know that? Well, it's through the angel of the Lord, or the angel of Yahweh. Now, the angel of Yahweh is God. How do we know that? Well, do you remember when God appeared to Moses in the burning bush? Who was it? It was the angel of Yahweh. And what did the angel of Yahweh say? I am the God of thy fathers. I am the God of Abraham, of Isaac, and Jacob. That's the angel of Yahweh speaking. But wait a minute. In Judges 13, we are told that Yahweh sent the angel of Yahweh into the world. Now, here's the thing. In Genesis 16, the angel of Yahweh ministers to Hagar. In Genesis 22, the angel of Yahweh is the one that stopped Abraham's hand from sacrificing Isaac. Now, many scholars believe that this angel of the Lord is none other than a pre-incarnate appearance of Jesus Christ. And here's the thing. When you look at the ministries of the angel of Yahweh in the Old Testament and Jesus Christ in the New Testament, they are parallel, point by point. You see, so it's a fascinating study.
It really, there's so much in this book. We don't have time to go further, but incredible revelation in this book, the story that started it all, Genesis. I love Genesis,
but
people will love it that much more when they read this and they see just how much is really in there.
Ron, oh, it's exciting.
Love your stuff. With Ron's insightful book, 40 Days Through Genesis, you're going to uncover mysteries from the beginning of time, and they're essential in understanding God's plan for the future and for you. Genesis to Revelation, all inspired by God. Next, did King Solomon and the Queen of Sheba really have descendants, and are they dwelling today in the land of Cush? Well, I believe the answer is yes, and they need your help. Take a look.
Your gracious gift in support of the work of Jewish Voice right now will make you a vital part of providing life-saving medical help to some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. Today, we are urgently preparing for one of our next medical clinics to bless a remote lost tribe community in Zimbabwe, the Lemba, who consider themselves descendants of the priestly tribe of Levi, who have been practicing distinctly Jewish customs for centuries. Our medical teams provide more than just physical care and comfort. They share God's love and the good news that Jesus is their true Messiah. Today, we urgently need your help to equip and fund this vital outreach. Will you be a blessing to these suffering Jewish people? Time is literally running out for many of the most vulnerable there, especially infants and toddlers, and that without our immediate help, some of these precious sons and daughters of Abraham may die needlessly for lack of basic medical care. But you can help save them. But we must act now. Call or click to share life-saving help right now, and we'll send you two very special resources as an expression of our thanks. For any gift of support today, we will send you Ron Rhodes' unique and enlightening 40 Days Through Genesis, Discover the Story That Started It All, the exciting book mentioned on today's broadcast. You'll also receive Jonathan Burness's remarkable CD teaching titled The Gospel According to Moses, revealing the startling truth that for centuries before the birth of Messiah, the gospel message was embedding in Psalm 90, a prayer of Moses. Both are yours when you share any gift in support of the life-changing outreaches of Jewish Voice. And if God has blessed you with the means to share a gift of $150 or more today, we have even more gifts to share as an expression of our gratitude. In addition to the two resources just mentioned, we'll also send you a beautiful and inspiring work of art, a three-dimensional replica of the Ark of the Covenant, carried by members of the priestly tribe of Levi. Plus, Jonathan Burness's eye-opening 2-CD teaching titled God's Plan for Israel. Finally, as an ongoing expression of our thanks for choosing to help so many in need, you'll also receive our illuminating and inspiring magazine, Jewish Voice Today. Please remember, God has promised to bless those who bless the Jewish people. To share an urgently needed gift in support of this vital outreach and request your thank you resources, please call, click, or write now. And remember, your generous gift will make you a part of extending life-saving medical help to some very needy Jewish people. Please remember, the days are short and the needs of these people are critical. Please act now.
I want to show you now a tribe in Zimbabwe. Listen to this now, that's retained Old Testament traditions and rituals for over 2,500 years. They're called the Lemba. We recently held a wonderful outreach to provide medical care, dental care, eye care, even eye surgeries in the middle of the bush of Zimbabwe, and it was people just like you that made a difference in their lives. Take a look.
No.
In one of the most remote areas of southern Zimbabwe, a team of 51 volunteers were joined by 120 national workers. And together, they just finished one of the most challenging and rewarding Jewish Voice outreaches to date. In a week full of both work and ministry, the Lord's hand was clearly seen as Jewish Voice conducted its very first medical outreach to the impoverished Lemba Jewish community.
We've seen children who couldn't speak, they couldn't hear, they couldn't do anything. I'm shocked. And then they can speak, and they can hear, and they can say their names. Babies that there was this 18-month-old baby that couldn't even stand up or sit up, nothing. And then it had witchcraft bracelets on its wrist. They were cut off, and the baby sat up immediately. I mean. eyes to see with adults. I've seen so many miracles. My heart is just filling up. I'm forever going to be changed over this entire experience. It's the best thing that has ever happened to me.
In the afternoon, I was starting to feel pretty tired. My compassion level for patients was dropping. And all of a sudden, the nurse came into my room and said, "Can you see this patient outside?" And I said, feeling tired, "Well, can't they carry the patient into my room?" And she's like, "Well, she looks pretty sick." So I went outside, and I go up to this cart that is being drawn by two donkeys, near death look on this young female who is dying from AIDS. And I find out that she's come 8 kilometers to seek help. And it was kind of like a slap upside my head, because 2 minutes before that, I'm in my room feeling sorry for myself. And that was just God saying, "How do you feel now?" And I didn't know what to do. I see a dying woman and I can't help her. But as a man of God, I can share love. I can show compassion. And that's not easy for me to do, but God working through me made it very easy.
The Lord is looking down on this with favor, and He's looking down on this that He loves culture and He loves diversity. And I had such a warm, wonderful feeling that the Lemba here are very gentle and loving people, and that the Lord has not forgotten them, and that they have retained as much as they possibly can of their culture and of their Jewishness.
It's an absolutely amazing experience to meet these people. It's in the middle of nowhere, in the bush of Zimbabwe. And if you'll come, God will not only use you to touch these precious people, but He'll change you. You'll never be the same again. We'd love to have you join us in one of our next medical outreaches. And you don't have to be a doctor or a dentist or a healthcare professional. You simply have to love the Lord and want to be used, and He will use you. To volunteer, you can email us at outreach@jvmi.org. Again, you can email us at outreach@jvmi.org. And if you can't personally join us on one of these outreaches, there's still a way that you can help these precious people, and I'll tell you how just ahead. So stay with me.
The Lemba, a lost tribe of Israel discovered in the remote regions of Zimbabwe. DNA proves that they are descendants of the priestly tribe of Aaron, practicing their Jewish faith for thousands of years, not knowing their long-awaited Messiah has come and will come again. and the Jewish Voice Outreach Team has the privilege of sharing this amazing good news with them through our outreaches in Zimbabwe. It's amazing. Come witness this miracle. Be an important part of God at work in these last days, gathering His people back to Himself. We need volunteers urgently for this outreach, medical professionals, prayer partners, and practical service volunteers as we minister to thousands of very needy and spiritually hungry people in just one short week. Come with us and help these desperate Jewish people. Say yes to being God's hands and feet. Please answer the call.
Since 1967, Jewish Voice has been dedicated to proclaiming the good news that Yeshua, Jesus, is Messiah and Savior to the Jew first and also to the nations. Now, one way that we do this is by helping some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. We demonstrate God's love by providing these people with medical care, dental care, eye care, even eye surgery. And it's all provided completely free of charge. And most importantly, we share the gospel. With your help, we can make a powerful and eternal difference in their lives. I'm going to ask you today, right now, will you help? Will you be a part of saving lives, of transforming lives, and blessing desperate Jewish people in need by sharing a generous gift today? Now, if your answer is yes, we have some very special ways of saying thank you today. I've selected some really encouraging and important resources that I'd like to send you. You can call, click, or write now to share and request them. And remember, it's your generous gift that's going to be used to help some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. Hey, by the way, we're on Facebook. You can check us out by going to facebook.com/Jewish Voice and just click like, and we'll keep you updated about the great things going on here at Jewish Voice. Well, as I leave you today, I want to remind you, as I do in every program, the Bible tells us in Psalm 122:6 to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. And Israel needs prayer, your prayer today, more than ever before. And when you do, the Bible says you will prosper. Until next time, this is Jonathan Bernis saying shalom and God bless you.
Jewish Voice is made possible by the support of friends and partners like you.